So what is the best video editing software for Mac or PC? Well, in this video, I'm gonna talk about the best video editing software for Mac. If you have a PC, don't worry, we did a video for that, which you can see in the link in the description below or the card above us. So on this channel, we help you get the best out of your video editing and your filmmaking. So if you wanna learn more about the latest tech reviews or filmmaking hacks, make sure you hit that subscribe and that notification bell to make sure you stay in the loop with our latest videos. Right, so in this video, I wanna cover the different areas of the best video editing software, because I know for you, it may be that your budget is quite low at the moment, you may be getting into video editing for the first time, or you may be looking at it at a professional level. Maybe you've used the basic stuff and now you're ready to move on to the next level. So I'm gonna break the video down into a few different areas really, into budget friendly, into feature set, and kind of like how easy the programs are to use. So if you've got a Mac, the clear option I think for free is iMovie. This is included with every Mac free of charge. It's made by Apple. It's like a cut down version of Final Cut Pro 10, and it's actually very, very good. You've got multiple video tracks, multiple audio tracks. There's effects in there, there's titles. You can upload directly to YouTube, and it's very, very easy to use. You can even import footage very easily from your iPhone. Now, if you're moving up a level and you think, well, you know, I wanna do more than that. I really wanna take filmmaking seriously and video editing seriously, and maybe you wanna get into the industry, you can actually get free versions of Avid Media Composer. It's called Avid Media Composer First, and I'll put a link in the description below. Now, Avid Media Composer, I think it's one of those video editing softwares where it feels like it's being left behind. It feels to me like it's just being used by the older generation, but trust me, any professional level studio or film studio you go in, most of them will still be using Media Composer. It's still one of the best selling keyboards here at Editor's Keys as well, so it just shows that the audience is still there. Now next, it's DaVinci Resolve. If you wanna do a little bit of color correction, if you wanna get more into that area and you wanna do something a little bit more complex than iMovie, DaVinci Resolve is also free, and it's incredible that software like this is available for free. What I would say the pros and cons are for DaVinci Resolve is that obviously the biggest pro is that it's free. It looks very nice. If you're coming from maybe Final Cut or even iMovie, it has that same kind of UI. It has that same kind of theme. So just from a usability point of view, I think it makes it a little bit easier than Media Composer to jump into. But with that said, it has so many pages now. It has an ingest, it has a cut page, it has an edit page, it has stuff for color correction, stuff for audio correction, so it can be seriously overwhelming. I mean, if you want to do this as a full-time job, get it, because you know there's nothing that the program can't really do for free. So that's DaVinci Resolve. We'll put a link in the description below if you want to check that one out. Now, there's two proper serious recommendations, and if you've got a Mac, then Final Cut Pro 10 is often the most obvious choice. The advantages of Final Cut Pro 10 is that it's made by Apple, so it works pretty flawlessly with your Mac. There's very little render time, it's very, very fast. It's very easy to use, especially if you've been using iMovie, which is free, and you jump over to Final Cut. Now, until recently, not a lot of people know about this, but there is a free trial of Final Cut Pro 10 hidden away on the Apple website. I've found it for you, and I've put the link below in the description, so make sure you check that out if you want to use Final Cut Pro 10 for free for 30 days. If you do want to buy it, it's roughly £299 here in the UK. The price does vary depending on your region. But the beauty of Final Cut Pro 10 and that price is that the updates are free, so you don't have to pay for a new version every single year. And really, for it sounds like a lot, that amount of money, but for a video editing package that you can use year on year professionally, and it has everything that you could possibly need in it for most film editors, it's very, very good value for money, I believe. You know, it's very, very good. Its limitations are that compared to the Adobe Creative Cloud, which I'm going to recommend next, is that the integrations it has aren't quite as good as Premiere's. It's maybe not used as much as Premiere in the industry. And if you have a job and then, you know, you're used to using a Mac and Final Cut, and then you get a job at a studio and they say, right, we're on Premiere on a PC, you may struggle to make that jump. There is quite some differences between Final Cut and Premiere, which are you know, quite notable, it's often best to stick with one rather than jumping backwards and forwards. I mean, if you can edit, you'll know roughly what to do, but it's just finding your way through menus and things like that, which make it very difficult. So that's Final Cut. Adobe Premiere is probably what I would recommend for a lot of serious video editors, just simply because you can get it on a Mac or PC, which is great if you ever decide to move back to a PC or to a PC for the first time. And it has great integration with programs like Photoshop, with Adobe After Effects. If you want to do some additional special effects, you can use it directly with the link within After Effects. You just kind of right click a clip and it can go straight in and pull it back out. If you're cleaning up audio, you can right click the audio and take it into Audition, clean it up, and it just comes back into Premiere perfectly. What I would say the downsides are is that it's a little bit slower than Final Cut, just out of the box. You know, Premiere handles graphics cards a little bit better, so depending on your system, it may work better, but generally, if you've got a MacBook Pro, you may find Final Cut renders and works a little bit quicker just out of the box. Secondly is the price. So Final Cut, you have to chuck out this big lump sum and you've got the software there. Premiere has a few different options. You can pay for it on a monthly basis, which for some people, for cash flow, is potentially quite good. If you're only paying sort of $40, $50 a month for the entire Creative Cloud, you've got more tools at your disposal. And you know, if you're getting a job every month, that cash flow may be better for you as sort of an accounting purpose. If you're a student and you want to use Premiere, there's a whole heap of student discounts where you can get the entire Creative Cloud package, either one app or the entire package, usually for like more than 50% off. But in terms of the editing stuff, it's about as difficult to use as Final Cut, but there's some great training out there. So if you want to learn Premiere, we have some, or Final Cut, if you want to learn either of those, we have some great tutorials on this channel. But if you specifically want to learn Premiere, check out the Premiere Gal channel. She's a good friend of ours, and she can teach you Premiere from start to finish. So let me know, what are you filming? What are you editing? Where do your final videos want to end up? Leave a comment in the section below here, and I'll get back to every single question, because as I say, sometimes the best video editing software may not be the best video editing software for you. But let me know, I'd love to see your thoughts, and then watch the next set of videos. This is for PC and Mac and iOS. We've got the whole series here. So whatever you're using, we'll help you find the best video editing software. See you in the next one.